Hello students, myself Sarita, biology lecturer, Government Girls Senior Secondary School, Jandiala. Today we will study RNA world and DNA replication. So, when the life originated, which was the genetic material, whether it was DNA or RNA, that was the question. So, RNA was the first genetic material. There are evidences that prove that tRNA was the genetic material when life originated. Processes like metabolism, translation and splicing, they are all carried out in the presence of RNA. So what are these processes? Metabolism means all the activities which are occurring in the body. Translation means messenger RNA forms proteins. And splicing means when premature messenger RNA forms messenger RNA. So by RNA splicing, exons, introns are removed and all the exons, they form the mature RNA. So RNA acts as a genetic material and acts as a catalyst also. Catalyst means it helps the reactions to occur fast. In living organisms, important reactions are catalyzed by RNA. So RNA is reactive and less stable, therefore DNA evolved from RNA. So earlier life, it was having RNA as a genetic material when the life originated on the earth. So there the transformation in RNA took place and there was a formation of DNA. DNA is stable as compared to RNA. DNA is double stranded, whereas RNA is single stranded. DNA is stable and the strands are complementary to each other and the bonds are formed between the two strands. The main bonds are the hydrogen bonds. If change in DNA occurs, it is corrected by the DNA repair system. So now we will discuss DNA replication. So DNA replication, it is the process of formation of DNA from DNA. So DNA has a double strand. It is a helical structure which we studied earlier, that it was given by Watson and Crick. And it also shows that DNA forms new strand. And the process by which DNA forms new strand is known as semi-conservative method. Semi means half, conservative means to save or to protect that part. So this is the parental strand. On this strand, this is the other strand. And from this strand, new daughter strands are formed. And they are the exact copies of their parents. In daughter's DNA, one strand is parental, that is template strand, and the other copy, that is the other one, is formed, that is the red I have shown by the red one. So two daughter DNA are formed from the main parental strand. Now these two strands would separate and act as template for the synthesis of new complementary strands. After the completion of replication, each DNA molecule would have parental strand and one newly synthesized strand. So this is the newly synthesized, this is the newly synthesized. This scheme was termed as semi-conservative DNA replication. So templates will form a new strand with complementary base strands. Here one strand is parental and the newly synthesized is the new strand. So this type of replication is known as a semi-conservative replication. Now there is an experiment to show that DNA replicates semi-conservatively or conservative method. So DNA divides by semi-conservative method. This experimental proof was given by Michelson and Strahl. It is now proved that DNA divides semi-conservative method. It was shown in E. coli. So that was the bacteria in which the semi-conservative method was studied first. And in higher organisms, it has been shown that DNA replicates semi-conservatively. So the experiments were performed by the two scientists, Michelson and Strahl, in 1958, and they showed that the replication of DNA was by means of semi-conservative method. So first, before understanding the method of semi-conservative method, we must know what are isotopes. So isotopes, they have atomic mass is different in them. Atomic number is same, but atomic mass is different. For example, nitrogen, it has isotope of nitrogen is 14 and 14 and 15. So the N14 that occurs means the main isotope is N14, but N15 isotope, it occurs in low quantity and heavy mass of nitrogen, as more mass is than the normal. So N15 occurs in low quantity, that is the isotope of the nitrogens. Now what was the experiment? In this experiment, the scientists, they grew E. coli in a medium containing ammonia chloride, NH4Cl, and it was labeled as by means of an isotope that was N15, which is a heavy isotope of nitrogen, as only nitrogen source for many generations. So E. coli was grown in a medium. So here there is E. coli that is grown in a medium containing ammonium chloride. N is 15 here, it is a heavy isotope. Now this result was that N15 was incorporated into the newly synthesized DNA. This heavy DNA molecule could be distinguished from the normal DNA by centrifugation in calcium chloride. So the main purpose of doing this was that the first E. coli has a normal strand, that is N14. But for many generations, it was grown in a medium of N15, NH4Cl. Then, after growing in it, the DNA of the E. coli was changed to N15, because N15 was incorporated into that into E. coli's DNA, because it was all available around the E. coli. This heavy DNA molecule could be distinguished from the normal DNA by centrifugation. So centrifugation was carried out and it could be distinguished from the normal, because it was slightly heavier as compared to the normal N14. Now the next step was, so then they transferred the cells into a medium of normal ammonia chloride, then N15 NH4Cl was placed in a medium containing normal NH4Cl14, and then took samples at a various time intervals, means in between they took the samples. As well, and the cells kept on multiplying, and the extracted DNA that remained as double strand helicals, the various samples were separated independently on calcium chloride, the gradients to measure the densities of the DNA. Now this is normal DNA, means with N14. Then it was grown in N15, NH4Cl, and it got incorporated inside the DNA of N14. So the next generation that was formed, that was N15, NH4Cl. So for many generations, then it was again grown on medium NH4Cl. Here it was observed that they took again this N15, then it again took N14, because it was the medium around it, and it divided, and it was checked at some intervals of time. What were the observations? So here this is the DNA of N15N DNA, and after 20 minutes, that is the time for multiplication of E. coli life cycle, it takes 20 minutes to replicate, divide. So N15, then here this strands, two strands of DNA were formed, and it had one strand of N14 and one strand of N15. Now when in the next generation, after 40 minutes, the second generation, then there were one strand of normal DNA N14, two strands of hybrid, then again one strand of N14. So if we saw the centrifugation, here in first generation it is N15, two strands both are of N15, then there was when they were grown in N14 media, one strand was N14 and other was 115. Again after second generation there were two light strands and two hybrid strands. So we can say, according to the density, we can see that N15 is towards the lower surface, N14 and N15 they are in between, and N14 being lighter it is above, and N14-15 is heavier, it is slightly below the N14. So this is gravitational force of centrifugation. Now what happened is that in F1 generation we obtained two strands, one was N14 and the other one was N15. So when they separated, one of the strand was the parental, so this red one and this one blue one, so one was the parental and they developed one template strand, and in the same way the other DNA, one was the parental N14 and one was N15, and they separated N14 and one N15, and they got one they found one new strand complementary to the first one. So total when we saw, there was a hybrid DNA, light DNA, hybrid DNA and light DNA. Separation was done by centrifugation. So measles and Strahl experiment shows that DNA that was extracted from the culture of one generation after the transfer from N15 to N14 medium, after 20 minutes, E. coli divided after 20 minutes had a hybrid or intermediate density. So DNA extracted from the culture after another generation, that was after 40 minutes, composed of equal amount of hybrid and light DNA. Very similar experiment of use of thiamidine to detect the distribution of newly synthesized DNA in the chromosome was performed in Vixia faeva, that is beans, by Taylor and colleagues in 1958. The experiments proved that DNA in the chromosomes replicate semi-conservatively. So thank you.